My name is Harry, and I'm from London.
Meghan Markle here. The stupidity that's going on. All right, so there's more comment. Let's move on to the next one. I'm 29 minutes. So this is another video, okay? I don't know how many, okay, I might squeeze everything in one. I don't know. When I'm editing, I'll figure it out. Next week. Okay, so this is a response to the Valentine Low here, okay? So maybe this will be, I'll squeeze it with the other one.
No, it's all right.
Okay, Valentine Low, who works for the Times newspaper, went on CBS and tagged CBS here and lied about something that was seen in real life. I don't know why CBS Morning is platforming UK bigots on American TV network. All right, something went in my eyes. All right, so she retweeted that. Let's go into that. Weird, seeing royal reporters rewrite history in real time for an event we all watch on the day of the walkabout. The Daily Mail reporter claimed Harry and Meghan didn't greet the public. Oh, he did say that too? Okay, now the Times reporter glibly lies on CBS Morning saying they didn't ride the same car. Yeah, that's what I caught that too. Alright, let's see here. Rebecca English, Harry and Meghan viewed the flower tribute, but only William, Kate stays to meet. What the hell? Are you kidding me? And that was back in 2022. What? Oh my God. No wonder why they were trying to put this nonsense on my post. I had to go back and show it to them. See, now I'm starting to wonder. I don't know if I said it on my original video around that time where I did the PR 101, but this is why they brought in the guru guy. So they had a narrative going on, and this is why they probably had called Harry to come and join them on the walkabout to start creating for this narrative that they're going, that they're spreading right now. But I was aware of it at the moment, because I point those things out when I was doing the videos. And this is my IG post back in October 2022. I post something, right, regarding the event. And then someone commented on my post, not this one that I'm showing on the screen. It's another one, probably previous it. Just go on my IG and look for it around that time. And then I was like, what the hell are you talking about? Because I saw what I saw. They went in the same car. So I went back because I had the clip and I took screenshot. And this is one of the screenshots of that, where they came in one car and then they left in the, you know, in the same car. This is the narrative that they were trying to put. And it seemed like by accident, I cracked it the minute it came out. And I have the video of it. Oh my Lord, go on my previous video, video one of today's date. You'll see where I'll put it here. I'll insert it here. All right, what I did on video one. All right, because I did a little editing showing what was going on. All right. William didn't even bother holding the door for his wife. Catherine went in the front side. Okay. And then you're going to see, if they show it, Harry's going to come over on that side to open the door for Meghan, which is the back of the car. And then he will come back out on that side to go on that side of the car. So I don't know what Valentine Low is talking about.
There was definitely not any great personal warmth. Between the two couples, I mean, when it was over, it was over. They went their separate ways. Didn't even go in the same car together.
Oh my God. And the thing is that this never been confirmed. This is my humble opinion. I truly believe they called Harry and Meghan to come and walk about with them because they didn't want to get booed. Okay, when Harry and Meghan is there, they'll get the, you know, the same coattail of positivity. They know they're doing evilish thing. People don't like them, but whatever.
And when Harry and his brother William, along with their wives, met with members of the public outside Windsor Castle, there were hopes it signalled a reconciliation. But away from the cameras, things were reportedly tense.
There was definitely not any great personal warmth between the two couples. I mean, when it was over, it was over, and they went their separate ways. They didn't even go in the same car together.
Wow.
Valentine Low is royal correspondent for the Times of London. He told us it was predictable that Meghan would decide not to attend the coronation.
There's the thing that I was saying. Okay, let's move it back. Because when I was doing the other video, I shared this. All right, like around here, there's a couple things that I took away from this scene. Okay, it was their PR thing, okay, to get a photo, okay, because they had a narrative going on. Okay, they got their photos. I'll put the screenshot of the photo that I'm talking about. And then on the video earlier, I was talking about, without even seeing this, because I remember on top of my head, okay, where I said he didn't even walk her to the front car. What's her name? Kate is going to go to the front and Harry's going to come around, open the door for Meghan, goes in the back, and then Harry's going to walk back here to go in the other side. Okay, is that the same car? Am I seeing two different cars here? And then you had the guru guy who was dictating to William what to do. Yeah, they had the narrative going. All right, let's watch.
Valentine Low is royal correspondent for the Times of London. He told us,
okay, there it is. Kate in front, gonna go in front here. Okay, Harry's opening the back door for Meghan. And there's William. I think William is driving. He's gonna go in the front. And then later on, Harry goes there.
It was predictable that Meghan would decide not to attend the coronation.
What would you read into that?
There's the guru guy. This is the guru guy who was dictating to William what to do. They had their narrative going. Oh my Lord.
She thinks I've had enough of this family.
And when Harry and his brother William...
Okay, this is where they came together. That's the part I was trying to look when I was... Okay? They came from that car together, and I think this is their security who was in the other car. Okay?
His brother...
But anyway, my God, these people are lying right in front of us. This is crazy. Okay, when I heard the part about them not going in the same car, I was like, what? You're not supposed to see or don't believe your eyes. That's the thing. You're not supposed to believe your eyes. Let them tell you what to believe. My God, the optics were bad enough without having to lie and embellish the story. Who is the female reporter? Okay, at CBS, so disappointed that you gave your platform for these reporters to lie about not riding the same car. Terrible. What I think they should do, I mean, I understand they need both sides of the story. Okay, some of you might disagree with me. But them who's doing the reporter, CBS, all right, because they were there too. Okay, they may not be there in person, but they saw the images that was going out. They should put the correction. This is the part that I disagree with CBS for not doing the correction. Okay, now, and my disclaimer, maybe they did, I do not know. But this is the clip that I came across. I didn't watch the entire thing. So if they did a correction, my bad. But if they did not, this is what they should have done. Because everybody saw the images that was coming out of the UK during that time. Okay, so this is the image that I was talking about. Okay, they all came out and that car. The security was in the back. This is the guru guy. His head is peeking in the back. Okay, there's Megan coming out on that side. They opened the door for her. And Harry came out to greet whoever that person was. You see, I don't even need the image to see. I remember it. Okay. No, I think Megan opened the car by herself. They opened the door for Kate or something. This guy opened the door for Kate. All right. Harry and Megan joined William. And my goodness. Let's see. I want to believe that most of Valentine Low's scoop that he gets is mostly fabricated. This isn't his first time lying on Harry and Meghan. I don't know why the US media is platforming these liars. I don't know. I do not know. Whew. Okay, British. I don't know if this should be a defame kind of. It's so freaking easy to sue these people. But Meghan is not taking action. Okay, it's not my thing to say, it's not my place, but it's up to Harry and Meghan. I want to believe that most violent. Okay, I read that. British royal reporters lie all the time and put things out of context in favor of their paymaster and palace. Their job is spin. But it says a lot when they lie about something so well published. CBS Mornings, you really have to avoid the royal voter. Good for independent ones. All right, let's see here. 7 seconds.
Though, you know, my job is to report on the royals and to be, you know, sometimes part of their PR spin. You know, sometimes part of their PR spin. You know, sometimes part of their PR spin. You know, sometimes part of their PR spin and be positive about them. Though, you know, my job is to report on the royals and to be.
All right, there's this. I guess we suddenly don't have ice. That's what I'm saying. Okay, give me a break. Okay, it's frustrating when these journalists don't challenge this royal expert. They let these liars spew their bios without so much as a side eye. That royal reporter clown show act doesn't work in the U.S. Okay, there's that. These people, the sheer audacity is unbelievable. Okay, how can one be so shameless to the point of lying and twisting stories about things millions of people saw in real time? Why doesn't the royal family put a stop to it? I was just thinking before I even get to this point here, before this get carried out, I think Harry and Meghan need to put a stop to it, because this is easily be proven in court. This is easily proven in court. There was absolutely no reason whatsoever to come here to defame her like that. Very simple. There was absolutely no reason for this at all to come and lie to the people about that. Okay, maybe this is something Harry and Meghan's lawyer needs to look into. Okay, there is absolutely no reason for this lie to spew like that. Like squeeze it in for no reason. Surely they don't think these lies help their brand reputation, do they? Okay, not a lot of people pay attention to the US, to the UK nonsense that's going on. So they probably caught a good majority of people already on this small little lie. And this is why I said Meghan and Harry need to have their lawyers look at it before it spread. Give an example. The same way they put, the tabloid taking pictures of their kids when Harry sued them. Was it X something? I have a video about that. Okay, put a stop to it before it starts. It spread like wildfire. This is easily proven. There was absolutely no reason for him to say that. No reason. Megan is not going. She's trying to avoid these people, trying to do all sort of things. If they want news, maybe this is where Megan should send her lawyer, tell her lawyer to send a this kind of thing to Valentine Low. Send a letter. Okay? Let people talk about it. There was absolutely no reason for that. Okay? I guess girl shouldn't be surprised when she doesn't get a scoop from the Sussexes, so disappointed. Okay, they project and make it up as they go. Accuracy is not the goal. Destroying Meghan is. That's the thing. And this is why I said that Harry and Meghan need to put a stop to this specific clip that I just saw. There was absolutely no reason for it. To cloud the people's mind in the U.S., it doesn't need to be spread here. They told her to go back to America.
If you want to be private, go back to America and live privately. It's pretty straightforward.
She did. Okay, they said they weren't gonna talk about her. Why are they following her and spreading the lies over here? Hypnotized by the sounds I'm breathing in. Hold tight, chemicals collide. Hold tight, dripping lights paint the skies. All because. Okay, there's that. They project and make up as they go. Accuracy is not the goal. Destroying Meghan is. He's no different from those British journalists and world commentators like Dickie and Vicky Orbiter, who commented on the Oprah interview that they haven't seen just to trash Meghan. Okay, they have to lie. If they report the truth, Meghan and Harry will be the shining star of the monarchy, and that will not go down well with Chuck. And Camilla and the royal rat will not be able to get scrum from the royal table. Okay, you know, to sums up what they did with the Australia interview, I did a review on. It's on my PYTE. What they need to do, okay, this specific, because it is so easy, very easy to prove, because if they bring the other one to court, what they did, the documentary he did, I think it's a documentary. Whatever I'm talking about, I did the review on. That 60-minute thing, Australia, the lie that they did. If Megan, if they were to bought this one, to specifically focus on that one, that they easily spoke about, they could use the other one, the 60-minute, the entire lie that they did, as an example as well, to strengthen their case. There was no reason for it. Now, I guess she's waiting until the sister's one is done with, so she need to bring that in their court now, because they're using other people to try to destroy her. This one is very easy to prove. Very easy to prove. Okay? Do some sort of a discovery. Go full-blown on them to shut them off. Okay? Let's see. I mean, it's easy for me to say from the outside, but sometime, I don't know, when will they leave her alone? Baggage for God. They have to lie. If they reported the truth, Meghan and Harry will be the shiny stars of the monarchy, and that will not go down well with Chuck and Camilla, and the royal rats will not be able to get crumbs from the royal table. But eventually they're gonna need the royal rats if they need things to go out, unless they create their own. But you know what about these people? They don't know how to create anything. Okay, they have people forget what actually happened at the time. That's how they rewrite history. Thank God for social media. Not as easy to do anymore. Okay, what? My eyes and ears twitched. Twitched when I heard that, followed by his nervous laugh. Okay, why do CBS this morning give these lies a platform? I spoke about this. All right. For the sake of this view, let's finish what's on the screen. Whatever's here. Why do CBS This Morning give these liars a platform? They have abused Meghan and her children for years. Why book them to keep lying? These people are not journalists. They gossip and trolls. Okay, the ease at which these royal reporters lie to fit their narrative. Okay, at CBS Morning, you will think American Network will be a bit more careful with who they platform from Britain, especially if they intend to ask them about Harry and Meghan and expect truthful answer. This is why I said Meghan needs to put a stop to that now, because this one is the most easiest. Is the most easiest to prove in court, because they did it on US TV. This is where it should go, in the US TV, and then show the footage and everything, clip by clip. Because I think in some courts they don't accept media like electronic stuff, but you could take screenshot after screenshot to show every move. All right, at CBS Morning is participating in more abuse of Meghan and her children by bringing this bigoted liar on their show to talk about some shiny hat party that we celebrate the 4th of July for, and he's lying and wasn't challenging at all. Hate for hire. Okay, at this point now, the ball is on Harry and Meghan court. They did that nonsense for absolutely no reason. Meghan completely removed herself from that coronation thing and told them, I'm not coming. But yet they come here in the US to talk about her, about that, and then to lie on top of it. Something simple they didn't even need to mention. Okay, that part alone. And if they say, why are you bringing this to court? Because Meghan have experienced the amount of abuse and lies that mounted and mounted and mounted. Okay, it's up to Meghan to bring this to court. This is easy to prove. I'm not saying everything needs to go to court because it's time consuming, but that one is the easiest of easiest to prove. All right, let's do a prayer for that. Okay, the last video that I did, I said prayer for light shine on us. Let's pick something underneath it. Same thing, because people need to see the light to remove themselves from the darkness these hateful people are spewing on those young people who's trying to get away from those hateful stuff. All right, Creator God, you made everything good, but evil and sin is destroying it. That's right. Deceit, selfishness, and envy are casting a dark shadow around me. It's affecting the people I love and the people around me. That definitely fit into that. I ask that you make me a light to the world. Fill me up with joy that is undeniable. Help me shine joy and love to others in such a way that they see the light of your love. Amen. I think this fits perfectly to what I was thinking. All right, so that's it. Please take a moment to subscribe, like, and share. If you want to support this channel, there's a PayPal link and a Cash App link in the description. You could donate. Those who have donated, thank you. And new subscriber, welcome. Hopefully it's a squaddy. I do not want haters on my thing. Even if you are a hater, put common sense comment on my comment. Okay, don't just come here to hate. If you do, I don't need your subscription. I don't even care about YouTube anymore, because YouTube, this is why I'm here. YouTube shut down my other, let me take that back. YouTube demonetized my other channel. And be ready for other, I schedule some stuff. Where is it? Okay, this was yesterday. There's gonna be two today. I schedule it until Saturday. I have four of them. The last one will be Saturday. All right, so that's it. We'll be right back.
Tanaka. It is a great privilege to be with all of you today.
You know, we ask for forgiveness and please come back.
As you saw me find the love and happiness that I'd hoped for all my life. Decisions that I ever made. You will be continually amazed how life changes for the better.